हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस वीडियो ऑन नीट ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिजीजेस इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय examfear.com. नो मोर फियर फ्रॉम एग्जाम. ग्रीन रिवोल्यूशन. सो ऑब्वियसली इट वाज अ रिवोल्यूशन एंड व्हाई इट वाज ग्रीन, दैट्स बिकॉज दिस रिवोल्यूशन वाज रिलेटेड टू द ग्रोथ ऑफ प्लांट्स. नाउ इट इज रेफर्ड एज द ट्रिमेंडस इंक्रीज इन क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन इन डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. So what is this, when did this tremendous increase in crop production happened in India? Now after independence, the major challenge for our country was to meet the food demand of the growing population, because living organisms, everybody needs food to survive. Now the population was increasing, therefore the demand of food was also increasing. Now how were we supposed to meet the demand of food? By growing more crops. So it was a major challenge because we were not able to grow as much crops as was needed by the increasing population. So during that time, by induced mutations, semi-dwarf varieties of certain crops were developed. Now semi-dwarf varieties of wheat and rice were developed. And these semi-dwarf varieties of wheat and rice, they have some very good speciality. That is, they were high yielding. That is, you get more yield of the crop, more productivity of the crop. At the same time, they were also disease resistant. So they were high yielding plus they were disease resistant. Now, because of these two advantages, these semi-dwarf varieties of wheat and rice was like a huge success. And this led to, you know, dramatic or tremendous increase in the production of wheat and rice in the 1960s. And this tremendous increase in crop production was termed as the Green Revolution. Now today, when you look at the various hybrid varieties of wheat and rice, you have a lot of them. For example, when you talk about wheat, you have high yielding varieties like Sonalika, Kalyan Sona. So these are some high yielding varieties of wheat which are also disease resistant varieties. Similarly, when you talk about rice, varieties like Jaya and Ratna, they were the high yielding hybrid varieties of rice which were produced in India. So in this fashion, not only wheat and rice, for all other crops also many hybrid varieties were came into picture, because these hybrid varieties had these two advantages: they were high yielding plus they were disease resistant. So this helped us to increase the overall productivity of the crop. So let us quickly look at some of the hybrid crop varieties. So here let's talk about wheat. Now in wheat, Kalyan Sona and Sonalika, they are not the only hybrid varieties. You have a lot more variety. For example, here you see Himgiri. So Himgiri is a hybrid variety of wheat which is disease resistant. That is, it is resistant to diseases like leaf and stripe dust, hill bunt. So now whenever a particular variety of crop is disease resistant, what happens? That crop doesn't get damaged because of a particular disease. So obviously that plant is going to survive for a longer period of time. So overall your productivity of that crop is increasing. Again, you talk about cauliflower. So in cauliflower, we have varieties like Pusa Shubhra, Pusa Snowball, and these varieties were resistant to disease like black rot. You have a variety in cowpea which is called Pusa Komal, and it is resistant to disease like bacterial blight. Chili, the hybrid variety is called Pusa Sadabahar, and it was resistant to diseases like TMV, that is tobacco mosaic virus, chili mosaic virus. So the name was also Sadabahar, that is, it is evergreen. So because it will always be disease resistant, it will not get attacked by the diseases. Okra or bhindi, the hybrid variety was Pusa Savani, and it was resistant to diseases like shoot and fruit borer. In flat bean also you have hybrid crop varieties like Pusa Sem 2, Pusa Sem 3, and they were resistant to diseases caused by aphids and fruit borer. Now Why did I talk about these names? Because obviously these are examples of famous hybrid varieties of these crops like wheat, cauliflower, cowpea, chili, bhindi and flat bean. Also, from NEET perspective, many a times you get multiple choice questions with the names. For example, they might suddenly ask you that Himgiri is a hybrid variety of which crop, and you are given some four options. Right, so these kind of questions are also important and they have come in the previous years in NEET exam. So that is why also you should know which is a hybrid variety of which crop, and that hybrid variety is resistant against which disease. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.